That goes somewhere else. Not to the garage. Gonna hold off on that. Barbara? Oh, I gotta... Wait. I gotta turn it.
Great-Grandpa Sven built a music box for Barbara, along with the rest of the house.
Barbara Finch. I guess that was Barbara Finch. But who's that? Looks spooky. Hmm. Upstairs.
A lot of things got left behind in the whirlwind of that last night.
I guess so. You serious with this door? Oh.
Edie told me once that every Finch who ever lived is buried somewhere in the library.
That's spooky. I'm gonna be stuck in a library. How do I... Back up, okay.
My mom wasn't much of an optimist, but she never stopped believing that my brother Milton was alive.
So... Milton went missing in 03. Lewis died in 2010. Guess we're not going out that way. Oh. That's cool. They got little letters. Little, everyone has their own separate thing. Edith Lewis Milton had nothing because he died years ago. Edie and Dawn. So it's stuck in November 2010. Oh! Yep. Someone was old, had trouble getting around. Hence that and the ramp outside. I've been in here. Right, I just came from a different area. Oh my god. So, salmon and Chinese food, basically. I wonder if they even mix the salmon with the Chinese food just for something different. See, when you make sounds like that, it sounds like someone's rattling a doorknob trying to get in. I don't like that. So the front door should be around... This way. That is the front door. But we cannot go that way. Alright. Guess it's locked. Our key does not go to that. So where does our key go to? So before I go upstairs then...
Mom always told me to stay out of the basement, so I wasn't too surprised when the key didn't fit.
Okay. Then we're just going upstairs. And we can use our feet. We don't have to go with that. Which is good, because there's no electricity
in the house.
After
Milton disappeared, Mom sealed up all the bedrooms. Then Edie retaliated and drilled peepholes.
When Milton disappeared, all the bedrooms? I mean, some of them would still have people that want to sleep there. Look at that. Unfinished chimney. Well, the bricks came loose. Either one. Okay. Get to that. That we can get into. That's cute. I like that. So this is sealed up. Molly.
Molly always seemed like a girl I could imagine being friends with, if she hadn't died in 1947.
Right. I'm really nervous peeking through these. I'm gonna see something I don't want to see at some point, looking through these. The Library of Babel. Time and the Gods. That sounds familiar. 51 Tales. A lot of these we've seen, actually. The King in Yellow, yeah. A lot of repeats. They have their favorites.
I spent a lot of time playing in Great Uncle Walter's room.
Great Uncle Walter with a great white shark.
I think my mom sometimes regretted not sealing it up.
Why did she choose not to seal it up? Okay, we can mess with that. That's awesome, though. I like that. You just sleep in here. Oh, it was like a collapsed house. A boat, right? Maybe. No, it looks like a house. With a chimney. Huh. Oh, this might be the sunken house that they were talking about. They took all the bricks from that. Something like, but it's cool. Because you would literally put your bed here. Or maybe back a little so you could still see this. And you'd be like you're in... like you're in your little aquarium.
Lewis told me there were secret passages, but I never believed him.
Oh yeah? Could there be? 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea, Jules Verne. I read that book when I was little.
Turns out, my mom was really good at keeping secrets.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I got open. Chapter 1, A Runaway Reef. What do you want me to do? Turn... wait.
Now okay. It was time to find out what my mom had been afraid of.
That was awkward. Should I be looking there yet? Hold on a second. I want to see what's down here. That seems like our ultimate destination, perhaps. So let me hold off on that. My big friend, Bigfoot. Introducing Barbara Finch, also starring Bill Bunton as Bigfoot.
Whenever people ask me about my family, the first thing they always want to know about is Barbara.
Well, she was a child actress, of course. What more is there to know? That's why she's in a casting chair. Got it. Mr. Bell's Bakery. Taming the Sea, A Fisherman's Guide. Oh, I'm not going up there yet. Secrets of the Stove. The Pleasures of Japanese Cooking. See, your mom had Secrets of the Stove. Yeah, same books. Barbara. 1944 to 1960.
Barbara was a child star for 2 years, until America grew out of it.
Wait. She only died when she was six. She died when she was only 16. How sad. What is that? What's that noise? Oh, you. Oh, I saw him in one of the photos. You look spooky there.
Edie's father, Odin, built the original house.
Odin. Right, so we can see them here. Odin, Edie, and they lived it well. He only lived to be 57. Edie lived, so she was, oh, I'm horrible at math. What was that, 93? Walter lived for 53 years. Sam for 33. Calvin died 11 years old. Barbara died 16 years old. Molly died 10 years old. Gregory died a year old? How sad. Gus died at 13. Dawn died... Well, sorry. That's, 48? I think. 70... 32... Yeah, 48. Edith. That's, well, me, sort of. Milton died at 11. Lewis died... How old is he? 22? Yeah. Okay. Too bad I can interact with this and open this. So you've got this cord going all the way up to that. Alright. And nice little reading nook. You can overlook. You got a lot of light. Big window here. Be a great place to sit and read. Definitely got a lot of books to read. Well, it looks like a lot of books, but it's basically the same 30 books repeated over and over again. How many copies? I'll read this copies of Raw Fowl now. Calvin and Sam? Maybe Sam's the middle name?
My Grandpa Sam spent 7 years sharing a room with his dead brother, oh. Calvin.
What? He shared a room with his dead brother? Naturally, they took the brother out before he... Oh, I don't even know. And Gregory, who's a year old.
As a kid, I just assumed every house had peepholes and sealed rooms you weren't allowed inside of.
Yeah, right. I'm seeing that right. A year old. Sven and Edie. Sven Hofstad Finch. He's here. You know, I wasn't sure what that was. I thought maybe... Oh, Ingborg? They're not attached. Adopted, maybe?
The last time I was in Edith Senior's room, I was 10 and she was painting my portrait.
Edith Senior. Oh. Okay, so that's that. So we've got this attic, and we've got dead-end rooms we can't get into, and we've got this. So let's check out the secret now. I want to see the secret. interesting music.
From the paintings on the wall, it was clear my brother Milton had been here before me.
Yeah, Milton. Darn a kitty.
Reading this, maybe it sounds like I had a plan.
Did you have a plan?
But I had no idea what was behind that door.
I'm gonna... Is there anything else in here? Some books or something we can't look at. Really, there's not much around here. They have little tea parties. And with the stuffed animals, I'm betting. Oh yeah, see, they have tea ware in there. I love the stained glass window. That's awesome. Alright, so I gotta pull or something. Yeah. Does this lead into one of the other...
I had no idea where all this was gonna lead.
Bedrooms? Molly.
I grew up looking at Molly's room through the peephole.
So we got in here. We got into Molly's room.
Being inside for the first time, I felt like I'd stepped behind a painting.
Right. That's a jellyfish pillow? That's awesome. Oh, she had a hamster, rat, mouse, something like that. Mount Rainier National Park. Can we open that? How sad.
I got the sense Edie had spent a lot of time here before my mom sealed the doors.
Wow. I am gonna interact with that thing, don't worry. I'm just looking. A Crook in the Cupboard. The Jungle Book. A Short Walk in the... That is blurry. I can't read that. Beast of Nature. Monsters of the Deep. Look at that. You got a scorpion. Some kind of... Oh. Is that rhinoceros beetle? See that? Could be. With the wings. That's a cool clock. I love stuff like that. Stuff that you don't see much nowadays. Much of. Locust Island calves. Yeah, she won some kind of medal. For... I can't read it. Oh, that's where it came from. So there's another door with an owl, but let's check this out. Molly Finch. Oh, come on. Don't start creaking on me now.
December 13th, 1947.
Aww.
Dear diary, I'll be gone soon, but I wanted to tell somebody about what's gonna happen. It started when Mom sent me to bed without dinner. I woke up and I was starving. So I looked around for something to eat.
Don't tell me you ate your hamster. Who's still in the bed? We can eat leaves. Anything besides your little hamster. Oh, that is spooky as hell. No freaking way. That is Poltergeist right there with the tree coming through the window grabbing you. Oh. Don't eat your goldfish. There's a thing.
I thought about eating Christopher, but I held back.
Yucky. You don't want that without a side of butter or lemon, tell you that much. Okay. I thought about eating my hamster, but that's freaking insane.
The gerbil food was dry, but I didn't mind it.
Okay. So where's the gerbil? The gerbil got free how long ago?
My Halloween candy was all gone.
Hmm. Bathroom. I could eat poopies! Yummy!
I ate a lot of things that night.
Are those even real? I guess so. I heard a bird. That is one spooky forest for a little kid. Look how I'm walking all tiny and stuff. I think I just noticed that. I thought I was kneeling.
I kept eating and eating.
You're eating toothpaste. Yeah, that's a great idea. Why do you send this?
I heard chirping outside my window.
I've been hearing that. So then I grabbed a bird and I ate it. How delicious.
It was a barn swallow going back to her nest. I reached out for her.
Oh. Chain on the window.
And suddenly...
Oh!
I was a cat!
Okay. You're a cat. Got it. Brilliant. Okay, get the bird.
I tried to be quiet, but the bird was really scared.
Where's the bird again? I don't even know if I'm doing this. I'm moving forward. I am clicking keys. I'm guessing that's making me jump, or I'm doing it automatically.
Mom and Dad didn't even look at me.
Good, because I need some cat dinner. I mean, bird dinner. I'm the cat. I can't reach that. Oh, I jump far. Moments in this game you pretty much can't fall. Otherwise, I would have.
I jumped and I almost got her.
Stalking. Wait, what?
I could tell she was getting really tired.
The bird or the cat?
Now I was up in the big tree. I promised Dad I wouldn't climb it anymore. All I cared about was eating that mama bird.
When you promised Dad that, you were not a cat at the time, so it's completely different. I don't even know where the bird is. Oh. Yep.
Meow. I gobbled her up.
Wah!
And suddenly, I was an owl. First, all I heard was the wind.
Sweet.
Then I heard little teeth nibbling in the grass.
I'm gonna find a little field mouse or something.
Rabbits.
Oh, I see. Poor bunny. The bunny made that sound?
Face looking up and seeing mine through my talons. I swallowed him up, and I didn't chew one bit.
Good God.
Then I flew off to find something bigger.
What a ferocious little girl. Oh my God. What do we want, but it's bigger? So I can swoop down by going like this.
A mama rabbit.
Where? Where's the rabbit? Oh, I see you. Mama rabbit! Get... Damn trees! Can I go back up? I see... There! I'm ahead of it. Wait. I see you! Getcha!
She was almost too big to carry. I started choking, but I couldn't stop eating.
I guess not.
And suddenly, I was a shark!
Huh? What? Ow. Seriously? Okay. Let's wiggle thy way down into the water, I'm guessing. He's down here. Whee!
I rolled off the cliff and into the ocean.
That sounded painful.
I was hungrier than ever.
I bet. You're a freaking shark. Okay. A little burst of speed.
I wanted
gotcha!
Juicy seals.
Yeah, I'm trying.
I tore off her flipper and it tasted really good.
Bloodthirsty little kid, huh? You only want to eat the cute animals. Can I surface? No. Oh, missed?
When I opened my eyes, everything had changed.
That was a cat again? What am I now? I'm a snake?
Now I was a monster, and I smelled people everywhere.